this is our program. We are not that long current.
Se llama que no creo que por ti ni nada o que no puedo por amor para
Dios.
Aleluya.
Father, I lift my hands before
to pray for grace redeemed church. You brought an angel in this place. And you planted him in this area. And Father, through him you brought revelations to these people. Father, we ask for more in Jesus' name. Father, give him deeper revelations. Give him deeper understandings of the kingdom of God. Father, strengthen him in the name of Jesus. And equip these people with the ability to stand with him, that they may prevail in the midst of troubles. Lord, see what you have meant them to do. See how patient they've been. It is a testimony to you, Lord God. Equipping them with faith. Thank you for equipping them with grace. Thank you for giving them finances. The world will see and believe that the Son of Mighty God, the Son of God behind them, the Son of God who is in leadership of their lives. In Jesus' name. I need to lift up your hands before him. Say, Lord, you're worthy. You're worthy of all praise. You're worthy of all honor. I lift you up. I glorify your holy name. Thank you.
this is a worshiping church. You just feel the Spirit saying, worship, worship, worship the name of the Lord.
Amen.
If you are in Romans 5, chapter
5,
blessed be the name of the Lord. Somebody say amen. And we shall go in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, 2 Corinthians 8, 9.
Praise God.
But let's start with Romans. If you're there, say amen. The Bible says in verse 17, for if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one Jesus Christ. Let us read it. For ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that ye through his poverty might be rich.
Look at your neighbor and say, every hindrance has been removed. Lord bless the word. For it is forever settled in heaven. And I bring the name of Jesus. And I thank you. In Jesus' name. Let's have our seats. Praise the name of the Lord.
And when I read the word of God, I realize there are people that reign in life. In the Bible times. And even when we look at our times today, you're finding the church, some others are reigning. They are reigning in their finances. Others are reigning in their health. They've never seen a doctor in their life. Others can have any child they want. Others can go to any school, they can have what they want to there. Yet you find that others that love God and believe God are hindered in their lives. Whatever they want, they don't see it coming to pass. They find difficult seeing things happening. Somebody say amen. Come on, can you say amen? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible gives us a very good scenario here. That they that receive the abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign in life. So he's given us the criteria of reigning in life. There must be abundance of grace and the combination of the gift of righteousness, which tells me